Yeah, thank you guys all for joining us too for KARE 11 News at noon. We got a lot to get to today, but first, help is on the way for Minnesotans and Iowans dealing with devastating floods, from a presidential declaration to talks of a special session. We'll have more on all the recovery plans, but I know you're talking about news other than flooding.
Oh, absolutely. We're continuing to cover some breaking news that happened overnight, a deadly shooting in St. Paul. Got an update on just where the investigation stands and what questions still need to be answered.
Sure, and I know you've been all over that this morning, but first, let's look at the weather.
Yeah, looking for those dry days. This will be one of them, even though you will see a little rain on the radar. Much of this is not expected to really touch the ground, but 83 degrees outside right now, a little cooler than yesterday by a few degrees might be about it, but that dew point at 49 is what's making it feel so much nicer outside right now. A little breeze from the northwest. Temperatures across the region, we're going to find a good mix of 70s and some low 80s mixed in all around the area right now. And again, as I mentioned, we'll feel a little drop in that humidity for a time. We do have some clouds, a little shower activity on the radar, but again, these will be passing clouds and a drop here or there. Really not expecting much to be reaching the surface. Here's a look ahead over the next several hours. Again, we'll kind of hover here in the mid 80s. Good mix of sun and clouds as those clouds continue to zip through over parts of southern and central Minnesota. All in all, pretty nice day out there. I'm gonna let you know when we can expect a more spring-like feel to our weather, and then when we're gonna be dealing with some more rain coming up in that 7-day forecast.
Hey, thanks for the update, Jamie. Well, now to our top story. We continue to follow the latest from the Rapidan Dam since we first brought the story to yesterday at noon. Officials have confirmed a partial failure of the dam. Michelle Beck brings us the latest as crews calculate the damage there.
Really astounding images on the west side of the dam. Federal officials have joined local authorities in watching the dam under what they call imminent threat. The problem spot is here on the west side, where the water has cut a new path for itself. In the latest update today, officials say the water level has gone down. The flows peaked yesterday, making this the second largest flood on record at the Rapidan Dam. What started this is that huge pile of debris that plugged up the Blue Earth River. Local authorities say they're dead trees from the drought that rose with the river levels. They took out a power substation and a storage building, and the future of this home on the edge of the dam remains uncertain. At this point, however, the dam is still intact.
It's still a high level of threat and concern because, again, this is still exceeding the second largest flood ever of record passing through the dam. But it's slightly decreasing. However, it's somewhat flatlined at this point, what I've observed.
Authorities say the initial surge is going to be gone when it flows to Mankato, the city just up north. And as far as next steps go, officials say they'll continue their investigation along with the hopes that the flows subside. By the Rapidan Dam, Michelle Beck, KARE 11 News.
Thanks to Michelle for that. And nearby Waterville is also dealing with some of the worst flooding the area has ever seen. Morgan Wolf was there just over 12 hours ago and gives us a firsthand look at the ongoing relief efforts.
Close to 50 Minnesota National Guard members are in Waterville pumping out water and helping out emergency crews. This is historic flooding. This city has never seen it before. A lot of people are trying to salvage what they can by building up those sandbag walls. But we spoke to so many people that have water in their basements and they're just giving up hope. So they're thinking about when this water will go down, and it is not forecasted to go down in Crest until Thursday. So a lot of people are just bracing for whatever they can. Meanwhile, there has been a relief fund set up through Franson Banks, and so they are accepting monetary donations for anyone that wants to try and help out Waterville. Back to you.
Definitely an ongoing issue there. In St. Paul right now, the Mississippi River could hit a major flood state at any moment now. It's expected to happen at some point tonight before cresting this weekend. For the most part, St. Paul is protected by permanent levees. At this point, the city is also adding temporary levees. State lawmakers have been talking about a special session for disaster recovery, but there's nothing official just yet. We're also getting new video out of Iowa, where President Biden has approved a disaster declaration for counties hit hardest by flooding. More than a quarter mile from the Missouri River, homes in Sioux City are met with high water right outside their doors. In other news here, we're following a story we first brought to you as breaking news this morning out of St. Paul. A homicide investigation is now underway after police found a man shot in an SUV that had crashed into a tree overnight. Now, I know, Audrey, you were at the scene a few hours ago and have been digging into all of this. What do we know right now?
Yeah, Cece, obviously an intense situation out there this morning. Over 12 hours into the investigation, St. Paul police still have not identified the man who was shot and killed. They also have yet to release any details on a possible suspect who opened fire in this Greater East Side neighborhood. All of this unfolding around 10:30 last night. Police were called to the corner of Van Dyke and York. When they arrived, they found a Chevy Tahoe crashed into a tree. The man inside had been shot, and though police say first responders started first aid right away, the victim was pronounced dead on scene. Now, this intersection is right next to a park, and people in the homes nearby say they heard all the commotion, describing it all to police through 911 calls.
Those 911 calls reported numerous different pieces of this incident. Some were reporting shots fired, some were reporting a vehicle crash, and others were reporting that they believed someone had been shot. We're going to make sure that we do the work of speaking to all of them to make sure that we can paint an accurate picture of what occurred.
And the police department says they need your help. They're asking anyone with information to give them a call. Coming up in about 30 minutes, I'll have more on how many homicides the department is investigating so far this year and how it compares to last year. Cece, just an intense situation out there, especially as folks were trying to go to bed last night.
Yeah, scary moments for sure a few hours ago. Thanks for the update. Well, minutes from now, groups from the University of Minnesota will testify at the state capitol about an alleged pattern of anti-Israel and anti-Jewish incidents on campus. The Jewish Community Relations Council and university reps will be speaking on the campus climate following a days-long encampment that ended early last month. Protesters calling on the university to divest from companies they say are involved in war crimes. They'll discuss the school's handling of the incidents and outline a plan to move forward. Just a couple of hours after our newscast, Minneapolis Parks and Rec workers will be holding an informational picket. The group will be outside the Theodore Wirth home at 3 p.m., breaking down their concerns about pay and what they call poor working conditions. Today's picket comes less than a week before they're expected to start a strike. That strike would start Monday, which could disrupt citywide park services just a few days before the 4th of July. New at noon today, we're hearing from the Surgeon General. This time, he's declaring gun violence an urgent public health crisis. In a new advisory, he's demanding more action to stop the violence, citing profound consequences for survivors, communities, and overall mental health. This is the first time the office has focused on gun violence. Data shows in the span of 2022, 48,000 people in the U.S. died from gun injuries. The Surgeon General is calling for more gun laws, including a ban on assault weapons and universal background checks. InfoWars, the media empire created by Alex Jones, is now shut down. Yeah, court documents say the company is being sold off as part of a $1.5 billion settlement with the families of the Sandy Hook massacre victims. Jones was accused of calling the shooting a hoax. The trustee overseeing that settlement has the support of 8 of the 9 families to sell the company and split the assets equally. We're following a couple days of savings coming up next month. Target just announced their Circle Week sales are back from July 7th through the 13th. That means Target Circle members will see deals up to 50% off on some items. The store is also bringing back its deal of the day, which will differ throughout the week. Amazon's 10th Prime Day is set for July 16th and 17th, and it's promising millions of deals. This year, the company is teaming up with Megan Thee Stallion. Prime members can shop the rapper's Prime Day picks and get early deals on her Hot Girl Summer tour collection. Pretty cool.
Yeah, get ready to do a flip, Cece. In less than 2 days, some of the biggest names in gymnastics will be in Minneapolis for the U.S. Olympic team trials at Target Center. You know what that means, right? It means we're officially Gymnastics City, USA. Governor Walz signed the proclamation outside Target Field, kickstarting an entire week of gymnastics activities in downtown. That includes the USA Championships, a developmental program, and a trade show. Add in the trials at Target Center, and you get the largest event they've ever attempted.
Never before have these events ever been put on at the same time, let alone in one single city.
Winner of the Summer Games in Paris starting Thursday, a Parisian market will open on the Nicolet Mall. Tickets are almost sold out for the trials, but there will be a watch party outside of Target Center. We'll also carry those trials right here on KARE 11.